Hi, I'm Mark from Designer Lines. We really focus on young designers that are just getting into the market for about the first 18 to 24 months in starting their own brand of clothing. I'm not going to talk about the kind of things that you would find on the internet where they say that you can create a brand of clothing by printing your logo on a bunch of t-shirts. That's really a t-shirt, right? That's not a brand of clothing. And it's usually a t-shirt that they sell you, so it's not really making you a designer, it's making you a customer. We're also not going to talk a lot about the theoretical things that you would find at a university, because we really want to focus your attention on starting this company and making money as soon as possible, because the first 18 to 24 months are the most crucial. The first step to getting into the industry is getting to understand it. So we have a consulting module that is for free called Introduction to the Fashion Industry. But you need to understand where the industry was, what it was doing right, what it was doing wrong, and where it's going to go in the future, because COVID has completely disrupted the industry. You're seeing large brands and fast fashion just completely collapse around us. But that's giving opportunities to young designers and people that are coming into the industry from other industries to develop brands of clothing that really make sense for all of us. Sustainability is very, very important right now. Sustainability and ethical clothing are going to be the trends for the future. I don't really believe COVID's going to go away anytime soon. So these small companies and local brands that are focusing on ethical clothing and sustainability are really starting to succeed very well right now. So you as a designer are creating items of self-expression. You're doing something really important. You're allowing people to say, this is who I am for the day. And so you have to be true to that, and you have to be true to your customer in your target market. You have to understand them extremely well and what they're doing with their day. And right now, that comes from a direct connection with your social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Designers are really using social media and a website, because you're not going to look very professional if you don't have one, but they're using their social media to create that connection and create that dialogue with their target market, and that's going to be extremely important going forward. So the next thing you need to do is understand the process of design. There is a real process to designing clothing. That's why you have so many people going to university and getting a fashion degree. They don't just teach theoretical things. They teach the art of sewing and pattern making and drafting and draping. And there's a lot of skills to going into this. Now, you don't need those to start your own brand of clothing. Today, nowadays, you can outsource that a lot, or you can go through what's called OEM, ODM, and I'll explain that a little bit later on. But the process of design, there is a true process. It usually starts with a mood board, and that mood board would take you into either an anchor piece or create an anchor piece out of it, or sometimes even a whole collection, 10 to 15 pieces for a season, either spring, summer, winter, fall. But an anchor piece is like the centerpiece of a collection, and that kind of spins off into other garments. So if you are a wearable art designer, which most university students are, because that's what they teach, they teach wearable art, they really don't teach ready to wear. But if you are doing a beautiful wearable art piece with red feathers coming out of the shoulders, and it's based around some kind of concept for a movie or a play, you can take that anchor piece and recreate it, and all of a sudden it could become a ready-to-wear garment with maybe red color blockings in the shoulders. And that would then spin off into another blouse that might have red at the cuffs. But what that does is it gives the collection a totally kind of cohesive feel, which you need, especially if you're going to make a full collection, which is what a small design company would normally do, about 10 to 15 pieces. Though I got to be honest, right now with COVID disrupting the industry and buyers being really, really cautious about what they're buying, capsule collections are doing a lot better right now. Also, designers that are designing around a very, very specific product, let's say maybe like a woman's blouse for business made out of woven fabrics. I don't know, it could be any kind of collection based around one specific item. But both of those types of designs right now are doing really well. Tight capsule collections and specific items for specific buyers. Now the design process doesn't just stop there. It's not just creating these ideas. You have to actually get into the technical side of design as well. And that is spec sheets and tech packs. Those are like blueprints of a garment. Like an architect would need a blueprint for building a building. The people that you hire, usually pattern makers, seamstresses, sample makers, they need to have those ideas come out of your head and onto paper somehow so they truly understand what you need and how to make exactly what you're thinking about. Now those tech packs and those spec sheets, those blueprints of the garments really get into also the fabrics and fabrications that you're going to be using. And that's really the third thing that you need to start worrying about is learning and understanding fabrics. That's one of the most incredible parts of being a designer because fabrics can really speak to you in ways that nothing else can in this industry. A lot of them are so unique and so beautiful, and fabrics have such intricacies that they will help you spin off ideas. Now, in my opinion, finding your fabrics first is the most crucial step in all of the design process. If you can sit there and sketch and draw these beautiful ideas, but not find the fabrics that actually work for those garments, or if, let's say, the minimums are too high because of who you're buying those fabrics from, you've just wasted a lot of time, money, and energy on ideas that you can't really bring to fruition. So if you find your fabrics first, I think it will help you with the creative process right off the bat. So when you do find your fabrics first, that will inspire lots of different things. If you find a beautiful wool coating that you absolutely love, the ideas of the different coats that you could make out of it are going to start to become very easy to think of. So that next step really is planning out that business. You want to make a business plan, and a really good business plan that's specific to your niche, specific to your product, specific to your message, and specific to you as an artist and what you want to be doing during your day. It's going to have to be conservative, it's going to have to be real and true, but it's also going to have to be very detailed. You usually want to break up a business plan for the first year by month, and then for the second year by quarter. And that will give you an understanding of where you will be during each of the different processes for the first 18 to 24 months. Now at Designer Lines, we do have a consulting module that we walk you through and actually help you write this business plan. It's not just something that you can get a template business plan off the internet and start to develop. We really want to help you write your own business plan that's specific to you and your business model. Once you have a business plan and once you have an action plan and know exactly where you're going to go and what you're going to do and how you're going to make money for the first maybe 18 to 24 months, then you need an understanding also about how you're going to be selling these things. What are going to be your sales channels? Finding the correct sales channels is extremely important. Right now, it's pretty much the internet. Malls have been shut down, retail stores are not doing well, large brands and fast fashion have just left billions of dollars worth of orders on the manufacturing floor, and who got hurt? Well, it was the sewers, it really was, because they didn't get paid. So the industry is in complete disruption right now, but that gives you an opportunity to figure out how you are going to be able to sell this, the clothing that you're creating. So those sales channels that you're going to be developing are pretty much on the internet right now. You're going to have to develop a social media following that stays true to your vision and has people that are like-minded or have things in common with you and the things that you're going to be designing. The next step would be to develop a nice little website. You can't be a professional any longer. You can't be seen as a professional if you don't have your own website to be able to sell and buy clothing. Then you need to kind of merge the new school and the old school, the internet and social media with the physical presence that you need as a designer. Fashion shows, the way they were run, just aren't being done any longer. So you need to think more about trunk shows and small local events that you can combine with your social media and your internet presence. So again, I welcome you. Please subscribe to the channel. I'm going to be coming out with a new video that will be called Introduction to the Fashion Industry. It's going to be a smaller breakdown of the consulting that we do over at Designer Lines, but I think that will help you to understand the industry really, really specifically. Thanks a lot.